Hello, my name is Tor, and I'm from Linolie and Pigment. Today I'd like to make a little video of how to treat a piece of wood with our satin wood oil. Perhaps it might end up looking like this, or who knows what color we're going to deal with today. Follow us! First of all, we need some cloths. The cloths, they have to be made of cotton. So it could be an old t-shirt fabric or an old towel or so. Then you also need some water in a bucket together with a cloth. You need some gloves and some sandpaper. And of course, then we have the wood that we would like to apply the oil to. Then we have some sponges, the oil, and an instruction. What's important before you start is that the type of wood you choose for your job that is untreated. It may not have been varnished or oiled or filled up with soap. It has to be a pure piece of wood that's untreated. The sort of wood that you're using is actually more or less up to you. Some sorts are just better, I think, for the oil. For instance, this one here is Douglas. Douglas takes in the oil so prettily. You can also use oak, ash, or perhaps birch. So the first thing we are going to deal with is our bucket with water and the cloth. We'll just wrung the cloth so it still contains lots of water, and then we'll apply the water to the wood, and that's to make the veins rise so it can obtain the oil in the very, very best way. So that's it. And now we just have to leave it until it's dry. So now the surface is dry again, and it's time for sanding. You have to use a grit 120 for your job and be very thorough in what you do here. Sand quite well. Always sand in the direction of the veins. Never across the veins, but always this way. So now we have been sanding with a grit 120, and now it's time for sanding with a grit 150. And again, be thorough. Time to humid the surface. Final time, wrung the cloth, not too much, it needs to be quite wet. Apply it to the surface. There we are, and let it dry. So now it's time for the oil job, and for that it's important to wear some gloves because this is extremely colorful. So you can shake it, but that's not enough. You actually need to stir it before we apply it. So I just use my fingers because it's so small, this little tester here. And then you apply the oil just by pouring over the wood like that. And then you use one of the sponges that we have sent you. Just rub it in. And in such an amount that the surface is filled with oil all over. It may not dry out. It has to be full of oil like this so it can soak in. And then we do the same on the rear side. So it needs to be well saturated, as it is here. And then you can leave it, for instance, on two sticks like that, just upright standing. So now this one has been standing and obtaining the oil for about 20 minutes. Now it's time for polishing off the surface, very first time. First, roughly, with this pair of gloves, just take the worst amount of oil and then take a new pair of gloves and slightly polish the surface here, more or less as you polish the mirror in the bathroom. Goes. That's the first time. Well, and now this one just needs to be standing again for a couple of days before being treated again. So now 2 days has passed by. And it's dry and it has been treated once, and we would like to make the expression a little more nice, and therefore we will sand the surface, and that will be done with sandpaper grade 400. And sanding this time, we really have to take care that we don't sand too hard, because then we'll just have the edges, they'll come and get visible. So therefore we'll just sand extremely slightly. That's it. There we are. And after the sanding, we're back into the oil job again. Stir it well. Just let the oil come to the surface and rub it in with the sponge. So. So, and now we just have to leave it again. Now it has been standing for about 5 minutes, and it's time for polishing off the oil, the excess oil. First you do it roughly, and then take some new cloths. There we are. New cloth here. And again, it needs to be the right cloths made of cotton. T-shirt fabric or so, and then you just polish the surface slightly. And always make sure that there won't be any excess oil on the surface. It needs to be more or less dry. That's it. And now we just have to leave it here for the next couple of days, perhaps 3 days, before you can start using it slightly. Before leaving the oil job, it's always important to take the cloths and place them in a basket, and then pour in some water like that, because cloths might combust or self-ignite, and therefore it's important that you press out the air and leave the water in before disposing. There, that's it. Ta-da! The final result of our satin wood oil in the color Delft. But remember, this surface here, as it is now, has only dried for 3 days. This means that you can start using it now, slightly. Some colors need a little longer drying. Test it out. Does the color come off? If not, then it's ready for use. But take care in the beginning. It takes 2 to 3 weeks before it's 100% curled up.
So now you have seen how simple it actually is to deal with the satin wood oil. And remember, you can use it on furnitures, you can use it for the floors. It's just up to you and your imagination. So if you like it, have a look at our webpage and see if you can find some inspiration in the different colors we have. Good luck.